dragon. This deck music, music. You can blame Reagan. I'm ball maying without paying. Y'all playing, we playing. My Himalayan. Gelato, that's a sacrificial lamb. I'm season cam. No, no matter blam.
Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
The law. It's a shame, rhyme, crime.
Every other night I'm outside with the you ain't.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's Wilson Seahawks going up against Ryan's Falcons.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. A few moments ago, it was Desmond Trufant of the Falcons making their way out of the tunnel to the delight of this sold-out crowd as his guys get set to do battle with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And the slot man goes in motion left. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. It'll be a gain of 4, and that'll bring up second down. Second down to the offense in search of 6 yards. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. On second down, Wilson. And his throw's going to be incomplete. The intended target, Mike Davis, and it's third down.
Used to have a coach just tell us all the time, those scouting reports aren't just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
And incomplete on the deep ball.
Well, I better raise my voice a little bit here because one thing we can already tell, even in the first year in the league with this new stadium, it's going to get loud in this place.
Yeah, the old place was loud, but I think we're getting a sense that this place is going to be louder.
Yeah, they're riding that momentum of that 2016 team that finished their year in the Super Bowl.
And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Jones. And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. They needed some breathing room. He gave it to him. 11 yards and a first down. First down, Ryan. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2. Bobby Wagner. Coming hard from that linebacker spot. He drops him for a loss of 11. On second down, here's Ryan. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
Hey,
And this offensive unit, they have to face a third down and 12 now. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On third down, Ryan. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And they'll be inside the red zone with a ball at the 16-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
The former Gamecock here. This is Mike Davis. A gain of 3, second down.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to churn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
Now Wilson on second down. Underneath to Davis. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. On the carry, it's Davis. And some big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Looks to punch it in here from the 1 on second and goal. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the 1.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They've gotten it to the 1. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal? Wilson on the keeper. And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They'll try and run for the first time with Freeman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Throwing on first down. Ryan caught by Sanu. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Midfield and inside the 45. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Freeman again. And down to the 36-yard line here. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Second down, Ryan. Complete to Jones. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. That one goes for 24 yards. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him. Even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he is knocked down from the side at the 9-yard line. They'll get 4 there out of the screen, and it's 2nd down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Now Ryan on 2nd down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
7th play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. Again, Ryan. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off down at the 2. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Now Davis. They'll try to get forward, but he's going to be stopped in his tracks at about the 3. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Wilson. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
Now Matt Bryant on for the point after. And he puts it through. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. They'll run with Davis. He spins free. Room here to run. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. And 10, it's Wilson. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. That one goes for 24 yards.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think they were looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely.
I mean,
size, the hands,
speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, You light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. On first down, Wilson. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Dontari Poe forcing his way through there to drop him for a loss of a good 10 yards. To throw is Wilson. To throw on second down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You had horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right?
While we've got a moment here, Frank Gore moved up two spots in his game Sunday against Jacksonville this last week, Charles. He's now top five rushers all time in the NFL.
That's absolutely amazing when you think about it. The longevity of a career, the production of a career, and now you stop. I don't care who you are, you start thinking legacy, right? And think about who he moved past. He moved past Jerome Bettis, Hall of Famer, LaDainian Tomlinson, Hall of Famer. If you're Frank Gore, you're thinking your credentials are going to be up for the Hall of Fame.
Absolutely. Start measuring for that jacket. He's at 13,697 yards.
Now Ryan on first down. It's caught over the middle. Hooper. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does. And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Throwing again, Ryan. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Mohamed Sanu. 2-yard touchdown grab, and the Falcons will add on to their lead.
And that lead is now 7, with a chance to go to 8 or more if they want to get crazy here, which we don't expect, but I just know the way the game's being played with the analytics, there's going to be a lot more going for 2 in a lot of situations, isn't there?
Yeah, there's going to be, and I think their focus here, they don't want to give up anything going into the lockers on the other, and just a little bit of time left on the clock.
Yeah, they don't want to do anything to erase the good feeling they have right now by getting this late score in the half.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off around the 37. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
After the interception, here's Ryan. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. Second down here after the incomplete pass. To throw again, Ryan. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And it'll bring up third down. Shotgun, Ryan. Finding Gabriel, complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Ryan. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. Ryan will throw again. This is caught. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones in the final seconds of the first half. And the Falcons will extend their lead. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-6. Here's Boscher to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And out now come the Seahawks. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown. And frankly, that should have been another pick right there. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. That their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12. From the gun, it's Ryan. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Brooks Reed in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Fourteen.
They'll motion the tight end across the formation. Here's Wilson, looking to throw on second down. And to the left side here, Wilson. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Well, they've gone backwards so far in this series, third and 13. From the gun, it's Wilson. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Grady Jarrett coming in to drop him for a loss of eight, and it'll be fourth down. On is the punter, Ryan, to send this one away. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. So out come the Falcons now. They'll try to get the ground game going with Freeman. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three. To throw on second down, Ryan. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Space to maneuver at the 40. And finally brought down right at the midfield stripe. 23 yards on the play.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Looking to throw on second down. Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Austin Hooper, 46 yards. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. This is taken at his four. And he'll be brought down at the 23. Make it the 24-yard line. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
15 yards through the air and a first down.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard. The tight end in motion right. Wilson to throw on second down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off near the 32. But Charles, he's thrown five picks in a game before. And right now, after that one, he's standing on number four.
And right now, your defensive coordinator is asking the offense coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? Because my guys have to keep running back out on the field. So play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more. But a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing it.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. Left side completion to Jones. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, his second touchdown of the night. And the Falcons turn that interception into a touchdown. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Here's Boscher to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. So the offense has it, 1st and 10. Shift together here from the D-line. They'll send the big tight end in motion right. Throwing now, Wilson on 1st down. And his throw here is incomplete. The intended target, Doug Baldwin, and it's 2nd down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Over the middle, complete. It's Richardson, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Now Wilson running left on the option. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play, because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option. And my goodness, another interception. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks it. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault.
And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Taylor Gabriel, 65 yards. And the Falcons continue to pour it on. So another score there. Often you talk about the 3 phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a 4th phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the 4th quarter. As Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a 1st down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Now Wilson on first down.
And now here is another interception. It's Desmond Trufant, and his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it, but it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in the game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Brad McDougal. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off around the 37. He's at the 30. 10. And he takes this one back into the end zone of the
As we go on, we go on, like we do, when it's hot outside, I wanna just chill with you, chill with you, what you need, what you need, put your little mind at ease, put that ease, there's a little sunshine in the summer breeze, oh, yes, yes, my.
Summer and it feel good. Stop now, top down, through the neighborhood. Let the wind blow, open up the window. That girl is poison like Belvia DeVoe. We have a barbecue to do at fall. Swimming pool party in the back on the low. And the plates of food will be laid out for free. Little kids, get down. I have a bus pull up with Tommy the Clown to do the jerk, get go to work and do that dance that'll make your whole body hurt. Playing Bombardier, Common Clear. This that time of the year for everybody to be boisterous. Rock with Snoop Dogg and rejoice to this.
As we go on, like we do, when it's hot outside.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Wilson Seahawks going up against Ryan's Falcons.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. A few moments ago, it was Desmond Trufant of the Falcons making their way out of the tunnel to the delight of this sold-out crowd as his guys get set to do battle with the Seattle Seahawks. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And spins away. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now and a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. On second down, Wilson dancing to
throws left. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall right at the 20. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third. A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Here's Wilson. He rifles one that's intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks it. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. And a great spot to start this drive from here. On 1st and 10, it's Ryan. Oh, it's a screen pass. It's complete. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 18-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains. They'll throw on 1st down with Ryan. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. 2nd down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if he continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Again on 2nd and 10, it's Ryan. That's complete right around the 8. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Ryan to Jones, the Falcon connection there for a first. The throw again is Ryan. And that'll be hauled in by the tight end. It's Hooper for the Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. And he knocks it through. Here's Bosher to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. They'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against teams that run the ball really well, because you count on your defensive front, the tackles and the ends, to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football and make a tackle. In this case, he introduced himself and said, "Hello, my name is Mike."
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now it's Wilson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. It's a quick turnaround for them after the turnover, but the way they moved it on their last drive, they're probably eager to get right back at it.
And you know me and you know my tendencies in this situation. What do I want right now?
Be aggressive.
Be aggressive. Take your shot right here.
On 1st down, Ryan. Looking downfield, a 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes, and when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
No gain on the play there, 2nd down.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last 2 drives. ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
They go play action with Wilson. And he's got his tight end. This is Luke Wilson. And they're going to get this one up past the 25. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They go play action here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Second and 10 now. Wilson escaping the pressure right. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The rushing numbers for Wilson may be down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. Shift together here from the D-line. On first and 10, it's Wilson. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Dontari Poe coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9. Now Wilson on second down. And left side here, it's Graham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A very solid gain of 27. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. Forced out to his left. And some room to roam now. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Second down, here's Wilson. The catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Wilson to Lockett there for the Seahawks first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
As they run left side and inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Now a play fake here on first down. Pressure brought in and the Falcons get there for the sack. Dontari Poe in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Play action. It's Wilson. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. And got to be a little frustrated here to not complete that on third down after having such a long drive going.
Hey, you're talking about going over 70 yards on the drive. Yeah, did you say a little frustrated?
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football.
But when it all comes together and you get the field goal block that's been designed, that's been drawn up, everyone has to feel good about it on that side of the ball. How about that one there? To the left side, knew what they had. That's where they wanted to be, and they got their designated guy turned free.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones, his intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Well, you know, we're in December, so I feel incumbent upon me to ask you about the MVP race and where you sit right now. Wentz, Brady, somebody else, what are you thinking?
You remember early in the season how strongly I felt about Alex Smith, but the way the Chiefs have played lately, losing all these games in a row, he no longer is a viable candidate. So you're exactly right. Carson Wentz in Philadelphia, he's got to be one of the prime guys that you're looking at. Powered them to 10 wins already. How about Tom Brady? His excellence is so, how would you say it? Every year you know he's going to be great, it almost works against him. Almost unfair for him, but boy, he's having a monster year. But if we don't have this conversation and include Russell Wilson in Seattle, we're missing the boat. Because without Russell Wilson doing what he's doing up there, Seattle is not in contention for a division title.
So it could be an interesting last few weeks here in a race to the finish line between those three guys. It
certainly is going to be.
The Falcons averaged 34 points a game last year, tops in the NFL with that powerful offense. And they're already looking for more here as they've got it first and 10. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. On second down, Freeman. And the snap will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. Two minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. From the 4-yard line, it's first and goal now. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
After the interception, here's Wilson, buying time to his left. And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down. Trying to escape the shadow of their goalpost, that helped 10 yards, first down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Over the middle here to Wilson. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. On first down, Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Being chased out left. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Second and 5. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now Wilson. Looking to throw on second down. Steps away to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Graham. A Seahawk first down. Wilson to his big target, Graham.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up the first down.
Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Partner's bad enough when you just can't hold on to the football. But when your quarterback's throwing it to the other team, that's three interceptions now, four turnovers for the game, you really have no chance to win the football game.
After the interception, here's Ryan. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
How about this offense? Already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive. They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and pressure advantage.
That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have. It's chipped away a little bit, maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, underthrowing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Going for the deep ball. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation, but sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And these guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, helped force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Final play of the half. It's Ryan. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And here now come the Falcons. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had an ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you're all looking for some
He's got the lane, and there he goes. The 20, 10, 5, and finally. Just a few yards short of the goal line at the 3. A big play there on the catch and run. 72 yards. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They'll run here with Freeman. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Still plenty of time left. kept in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation, but I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. On second down, Wilson. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Michael Wilhoit coming with pressure. He drops him on the blitz for a loss of 12. On second down, the left side completion to Jones. A good pickup there of 22. Fresh set of downs here. From the shotgun, Ryan. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Second and 10. It's Ryan again. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit at the 5-yard line. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. First and goal from the 5. Again, Ryan. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman with now his second touchdown of this third quarter. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. It is now 21 to nothing. Here's Bosher to kick it away. On the return, the All-Pro 2 years ago, Tyler Lockett. Did a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Ed One told me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, and that was a nice job of improvising, but it's not normal. Usually when the screen pass is taken away, you're taught to just throw the ball at the ground at the feet of the receiver so that you don't get it intercepted and just start over. But he ended up finding another receiver.
To throw on second down, Wilson. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Wilson now to throw on third down. And able to find Graham, complete. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. It's caught outright by Graham. And he's brought down. 10 more there and another first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
They go play action here on first down. Flush to his right. And some room to maneuver. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 11 more on that one and another first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Now Wilson on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. Now, the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field, sometimes the fighting for extra yardage doesn't come as a result. That and good tackling could lead to no yards gained.
Now Wilson on second down, eluding the pressure right. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. There they went for a big play through the air on second down, couldn't connect. Now it's third.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. Did they maybe play that too safely on third down? I know you don't want to just throw a ball blindly downfield, but that didn't help them a whole lot.
I think they probably said if it's open, take the shot. If not, get something safe because we do have fourth down to try and pick it up.
Here's Wilson to throw, and Graham's got it, complete. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. It'll go as a gain of 9, and it's good enough for a Seattle first. In the red zone this time. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Dontari Poe in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. On second down, here's Wilson. And left side, here it's Graham. And oh, a good hit there and knocked down hard. And they'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Now Wilson. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Vic Beasley leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six. Looking to throw on second down. Wilson. Well, the pressure gets to him again. Vic Beasley in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there. Hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. Escaping the pressure right. And my goodness, another interception. It's Desmond Trufant. And to the 12. That's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the two. Michael Wilhoy not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of nine. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. On second down, here's Ryan. Hits his target. It's Taylor Gabriel. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays. Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. He goes underneath to Freeman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Ryan wants to throw it. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player, not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. On first and 10, it's Ryan. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Second down now after the pass completion. Ryan will throw again. Throw left side complete. That's Jones. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks. Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Now Ryan on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers. And this will be caught. Well, forget taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. And what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them going along with those zeros in the time column, too?
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Falcons here as we say so long from Atlanta.
I done came up, busting down a whole broke, step back. Want your people swag. Ain't even gotta ask. What are those? What is that? Please don't touch my rap. Please don't touch my rap.
I'm racked up like rappers. I'm wrapped up on camera. Get out on camera. Squeeze like asthma. It's rare wrath when I wear wrath. Bear wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest into some rap shit. Look. Still shit rap,
and I'm dripping on rags. Rip gonna be the tag. Do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boasting, never brag. Please don't.
that's my rat. Oh, the Chris Van Nash. Alessandra Gucci glasses. The WN is in collab. Yeah, pop it like a Mac. Yeah, drop it on the. I'ma buy another. Cut, boys bring it back. Yeah, you know how to make it last. Plus, and keeping tabs. I'ma fly first class. Wave will hit him with it. Please don't touch my rat.
Don't step on my Russ Simmons. Do you know how much I'm spending? My closet, it worth about a million. Took a little off the runway. Next, in the kitchen. Ralph Simmons. All kind of crazy colors. Living color. Left wrist, roll it, ice. Made some Margiela my sweater.
Margiela.
Mama told me never settle. Ralph Simmons, don't lace him.
Ralph.
Got your bitch, wanna.
Huh? What? Don't wanna talk about the papers. I swear to God, these be haters. They be hating, I feel out of the. Living cul-de-sac, don't get along. Move, right with my neighbors. Diamonds on my neck and roll it on. Now I later got under the flavors. Done with my lightsaber. Ooh, feel like Darth Vader. I'm a boss, so you know I might riff it. In my basement, yeah. But you know that I'm gon' face it. Wait, that's the reason that they mad. Cause Lil Uzi, yeah, he made it. Yeah, I would have rap for I made it. Yeah, I would have rap for I made it. Yeah, got that rap all in my basement. Yeah, yeah. Once I got patience, yeah. I'm famous, yeah. Put my side inside Mark Jacob. Hey, making them plays with my label. I get it, I count it, 100 on my table.
Sterling Silver Lakers. Rubies red, my skin too black to blush, too red to. Six, nine pages. The saint on the green on the wizard up. Pockets full of mint leaves. Been smelling like it brushed tea. Say cheese, see the porcelain. Water, see the backwoods. Raph dragon on the floor. In it. I'm torching the road in these Gucci flames. Stuck to the pavement, they glued. I'm 2.5 million in the venue and 2,500 a tube. Like I'm sick with the flu. I cover my face and I'm that's spring summer 2002.
Yeah, please don't touch my ride. In the grass, Teddy with the Teddy. Quick with the hands, ready. Please don't touch my. Please don't touch my ride. Shirt off, I'm Cam, ready. Let's start in memory. Please don't pop my tie.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Ryan's Falcons going up against Manning's Giants.
All right, Larry, thanks. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. Aldrich Rosas, the Giants kicker, ready to go. And here we go from MetLife Stadium. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. First down with Ryan. Throws a quick hitter on the slant. That's complete. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. A first carry for the tailback, Devontae Freeman. And this defense not giving. Anything there.
there, maybe a yard up to the 36. An early test for this defense. Here we go on third and inches. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
That was a terrific job by the defense stopping them on third and short. But sometimes you get some visual cues from the offense, because when they're going in short yard situations, you might see the offensive line come in tighter together, a little more shoulder to shoulder, trying to wedge a hole in the middle. They didn't get it done on that play.
They'll run for it. It's Freeman. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. They hold him to only two there on the screen. It's second down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, but they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think there he had to come off of his primary receiver in a big way, just trying to get it to a secondary guy, unable to get that play completed.
Checked down, but didn't even have enough time to do that. Incomplete. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Third down, Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. A Falcon first down. Ryan to his young tight end, Hooper. And the offense lining up first and 10. Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
Hey, let's go.
A handoff, Devontae Freeman, trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. How about this opening drive? Play number 12 now. This is third down. Now a handoff. It's Freeman. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Well, that's the way you want to get an opening drive going, right? Because so often it's a tone setter. And I think even better when you're able to pick it up and convert with a running play. Because the last thing you want to do is play what I call rocket football. 1, 2, 3, kick.
Oh, that was dangerous. threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down. This is turning into a bit of a death march here, the 13th play of this drive. Second and 10, it's Ryan again. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. So after the INT, it's Manning. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. The 40, throwing middle, and it's complete. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end curling in the middle of the field. It's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Now a play fake here on first down. Flush to his right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Brooks Reed in there to drop him. And it'll be a loss of about 8. Throw on second down to Shepard, complete over the middle. That one goes for 24 yards. Just shy of the 5 at the 6. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Manning. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Brandon, some of those windows to throw the football that exist when you're between the 20s, they don't exist when you're this close to the goal line. But as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people, actually.
On second down, here's Manning. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Throwing is Manning. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Vic Beasley in there to drop him for a loss of 10. And it'll be fourth and long. And the kick by Rosas is good. And the Giants are off now to a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 18 yards the gain for number 18. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Remain here in the first half. We're back to East Rutherford, but first this timeout. They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off usually after about
Devonta Freeman. They're not gonna get him. Touchdown Falcons. Devonta Freeman, 47 yards, and the Falcons are in for six. Well, they were just hoping that run would pick up the first. They got the whole enchilada.
And I'm so used to teams on third down, doesn't matter how far they need for a first down, throwing the ball. Instead, they run it, and as you said, picked up the first down, and then some, and then some. In fact, everything, all the way for a touchdown. Terrific play.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now out come the Giants. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
On first down, Manning. He's going to lead this for his running back. It's complete. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From midfield, here's Manning. He rifles one that's intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks a 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able.
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. It's Desmond Trufant, and the return stops at the 39-yard line.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
After the interception, here's Ryan. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. Gave a glimpse of his power that time. And then brought down at the 30. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout, as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. On second down, Ryan. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. The Falcons averaged 34 points a game last year, tops in the NFL with that powerful offense. And they're already looking for more here as they've got it first and 10. The left side completion to Jones. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this down to the 8. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. First and goal. Defense with their backs against the wall. Again, Ryan. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper in the final seconds of the first half. And the Falcons will extend their lead. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. Here's Boscher to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
One final try now for Manning. Caught right side. It's Lewis. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Now Manning throwing on 2nd down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Throwing on 1st down is Manning. Eluding the pressure right. Complete. This is Lewis. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
A very solid gain of 27.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be second down.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play.
What a job by this defense all game long. They've come together and really said, no one's crossing our goal line, and they're definitely not going to start right now.
You can just see the dejection. Feel like nothing is working offensively. Manning going to try and throw on third down. Open man right side is Ingram. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over, that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't.
And he will score. Touchdown, Giants. Eli Manning taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Giants are able to cut into this lead. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard and you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Rosas now to kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter, so time to retool a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they've watched this lead shrink a little.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Now Ryan on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
The Falcons on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third down and 12. From the gun, it's Ryan. It's caught. Jones. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a first down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. They run from the pistol here with Freeman. And some space here. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
And New York set to take the field. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
They'll roll him out right, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Brooks Reed in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it, he's a big-time guy you have to block.
Throwing now is Manning. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. From the gun on third down, Manning. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. 12 yards on back-to-back plays there, and that's another first down. Now here at MetLife Stadium, it's the Giants with possession of the football but needing points as we start quarter number four. On first and 10, here's Manning. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down. Manning will try again on second down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it. But there was no trace of nervousness there. He was able to diagnose that play from his linebacker position, stay in excellent coverage, and bat the ball away.
A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Now Manning, gotta have this one. And this is incomplete. The Giants go on fourth, but come up empty. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total.
Basically, you're not going to outwork two guys very often.
Double coverage. I thought he was going to go somewhere else with the football. I get it. That's a stud wide receiver. You want to try to get him the football.
Yeah, sometimes you rely on him a bit too much. You forget the other options that are out there.
It's a give to Freeman running right. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
It's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the two. They're able to to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
They run. Devontae Freeman. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the two. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuffed from the two, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
This is Freeman. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Falcons will extend their lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. This fielded at the two. Turn here, he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And the Giants ready to come out now. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Adrian Claiborne in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
To throw, it's Manning. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Throwing is Manning on third down. It's caught, Shepard. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. From the gun, it's Manning. To Shepard, complete over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards. Manning now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another first down. Into the red zone now, Manning. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
Back to the air on second down. It's Manning. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Again, it's Manning. And he finds Shepard. Touchdown, Giants. Sterling Shepard, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer. And they will line up now for the 2-point try. Again, they'll throw with Manning. He's got it. So they convert the two. That keeps their slim hopes alive as we're back to a 2-score game. Rosas now to kick this one away. Andre Roberts now to return it. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
Now, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them, every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. Now they go screen, it's complete. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. One go deep, and the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
I know exactly why I tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him,
especially on those deep passes. The Falcons on third down. They have been superb, 5 for 6 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll run it now out of the gun. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. And now the Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So it'll be first down here after the run. From the shotgun, Ryan. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. A very solid gain of 27.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And he goes out of bounds inside the 10 at the 9. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that should just about wrap this one up. First and goal here from the 9. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Ryan going to give to Freeman on the draw. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. A nice pickup of 6 there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be 2nd and goal. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down 4th quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it out.
This is caught. It's Sanu this time for a Falcon touchdown. Mohamed Sanu from 3 yards out. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And that PAT pushes the lead up to 23 now. Here's Bosher to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And New York set to take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
On first down, Manning. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Shift together here from the D-line. Now Manning. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Shepard. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And that'll get this back down to a 20-point spread. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.